We can also add transactions to our personal favorites. We do that by navigating to the initial screen or the SAP Easy Access menu. In the favorites context menu, we choose insert transaction, and in the dialog box that appears, we enter the required transaction code. So let's go back to our SAP Easy Access menu. And now let's add our recently created transaction to our favorites menu. So we use the context menu on favorites, right click, insert transaction, and we type our recently created transaction Z001. We choose OK. Now our transaction test is added to our favorites. And if we want to execute it, we can just double click and our program will be executed. Closing development projects. Once a user has completed the required development task, he or she carries out a quality check and releases the task within the change request. The corresponding object entries are transferred from the task to the request. However, other developers can still edit these objects. Once all tasks of a change request have been released, the change request is released. This concludes the project. Let's learn how to release a task inside our SAP system briefly. So let's navigate to the transport organizer. That'll be transaction SE01. Inside our transport organizer, we can edit our current change request. So we're gonna look for our change request for the user we are using. In this case, this is my user. So I'm gonna click on display all my workbench requests. I'm gonna look for my ABAP training course request. This is the request. Inside we have the task. So this is the task for my user. Whenever we want to close the project, we need to release this task. So we use this little icon of the truck to release the task. In this case, we are not going to release the task because we are not done with our ABAP course. But in case you want to close a project, you need to release the task, and finally you release your change request. After that, you can transport your change request with all of your development objects to the productive system. You should now be able to name and use the utilities for orderly software development. That will be all the transactions we work with. Remember them: the SE80 transaction for the object navigator, SE38 for the ABAP editor, SE01 for that transport organizer. You should also be able to create packages, to create programs and assign your programs to your created packages, create transactions and assign those transactions to your programs.